and welcome to RLCraft. My name is Whisperfire, and I spent quite a bit of time at that pre-generated structure of the player base. I think it's the best way to describe it as a faction space. And you know that lapis floor? Turned out there was two layers of blocks. That took me forever to loot. But I carted off everything and brought it home with me. And I got my eye on another battle tower, but I had to take inventory over some of the things I lost, so I went ahead and bookmarked them. Some of the things that we've lost, notably, is our potion rings. And the potion rings that were lost were made before the update, but now that this is after the update, it now uses diamond and diamond blocks to get the same potion ring of resistance. I've also been looking through Spartan weaponry and decided on a rapier and a greatsword. So I got all of these items in my inventory ready to craft. So we got quite a bit of crafting in preparation of going to another battle tower. So let's go ahead and go down the list. And the first thing on the list is two potion rings. All right, prospecting. Okay, not bad, not bad. All right. Now, all right, it looks like it only does one at a time, so we can't shift click. Let's see what quality we get. All right, nothing. Okay, going down the list. Okay, no problem. All right, let's see, what else? Okay, I wanted a two-handed weapon, and I want to try the diamond greatsword. So let's go ahead and make one of these. And does this have a quality? No? Okay, moving on. Diamond rapier. All right, this is our one-handed weapon. And for the undead, we're going to do a diamond mace and a silver mace. Now, the reason why I want to make a silver mace is because it has a material bonus to undead. But the problem is with these maces, they have horrible durability. So, yeah, that's a little short. We'll go ahead and fix that in a minute. So, the next thing on our list is these two reforging stations. One of them is for tools, the other one is for baubles. So I think we can actually, if we were to delay, we could go ahead and delay the Bountiful Baubles reforging station. Oh yes, I need to make two anvils. Yep, I calculated everything before starting. So we got ourselves a reforging station and this other reforging station. Now, among other things that we lost our XP tome. Which is no problem because, well, it was empty. And there's an item that I want to try, the quiver. All right, so we'll go ahead and make that. Okay. Oh, excuse me. All right, now, the thing that's on my mind that I've been actually pondering for a couple days is these bandages. They come from three different mods. First aid, rough tweaks, and scaling health. So I went ahead and took a look on Twitch on the project pages for the individual mods because I was wondering why in the world are there three first aid mods in this mod pack and how do they impact the play, the gameplay. So I discovered that first aid disables health regen. But it's the one that adds the localized health. So when you hit H, you have all of these zones that you need to look out for. Rough tweaks also disables health regen, but when you sleep, it restores health. It enables the modpack maker, Shivoxy, to adjust how much health is restored when you sleep. Also, it enables mob drops from vanilla mobs, so you get those first aid items. And then, the last one is scaling health, which the bandages provide healing over a percentage of overall health. So it doesn't matter if you have 10 hearts or 20 hearts or whatever. 30% is still 30%. But it also increases max health. But, that didn't answer my initial question. Which bandage? Oh, excuse me, I can words today. Which bandage is better? Which one works? Honestly, I don't know. So, I'm going to make one of each. And we're going to go ahead and find out the old-fashioned way. But also, we got enough for one more heart canister. So, we'll go ahead and get that. And let's see. We got this for this bandage. This is from Scaling Health. That's the 30% restore. Then, we got Rough Tweaks, which requires a healing salve, which we got here. We also get it from Mob Drops. And then we get this thing that looks like a foot, a bandaged foot. That's the best way I could describe it. But this has been very cheap and very helpful. And it only stacks in 16, in units of 16. But I found that this is pretty good, pretty fast acting. Okay. Among other items that we lost when we were fighting the boss on the battle tower last episode was our armor. We got a set of armor, diamond armor, accumulated from the loot. But I figured it would be a good idea to make two sets of armor. Hear me out. Two sets of armor. In case you die, you can easily, very easily, let's go ahead and dump this away. You can very easily use your backup armor. And you can, not good. And you can get your stuff back instead of risking it being blown away and all that fun stuff. Alright, let's take a look. Alright. We got ourselves another heart. Alright, I'm gonna grab, let's grab four of these, and we'll try our luck with that, because we got one unfavorable quality, so we'll see if we can reforge that. And we got that one, which that's a major ouch, the negative 1.5 armor. So we'll go ahead and tinker with that while I'm thinking about it. We got ourselves a quiver, so we'll grab all of the arrows that we looted. Didn't craft these, we looted these. So, take the quiver, and if you right click, alright, we should be able to store our arrows in here. Mm-hmm. Okay, now let's go on to what's to be our reforging and armor and enchanting, and we'll just put these doohickeys down. Alright, let's go ahead and go to the better tools, and let's see if we can reforge this. Alright, I don't want to spend too much. Give me something. Ooh. Alright, let's roll it again. Alright. Nope. Oh, that is horrible. Yeah, that's a no bueno. Alright, we'll go ahead and get more diamonds in a minute. Alright, this one has no traits. Let's see what this gets. No. Okay, let's try this one. Hard, one armor. Okay, we'll take it for the armor bonus. Alright, we still... Let's see, where is it? Here it is. We'll go ahead and grab some more diamonds. Doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop. And while I'm thinking about it, we'll go ahead and store that away. We are just doing preparations for our next dungeon crawl, which is another battle tower. Alright. Let's try 8. Yeah, I'm running low on diamonds. I'm gonna have to do some more mining, which is loads of fun in a pack with Lycomites. Alright. Let's try our luck again. Ooh! Whoa! Legendary. Alright. Let's try this. No. I think we can do better. And no. No. Nice. Okay. Let's see. Oh, we're out of diamonds. Derp. Derp a derp a derp a derp a derp. Anyway, I wanted to explain the differences between the health mods. That's why I did a rundown of each mod with you guys. So, we'll go ahead and take our baubles, pop them there, and wear this. Alright, and I got a little note on notepad on my other screen telling me to remember the chupacabra meat. Righto? Rightio. Alright, and some of the stuff that we managed to get from loot or that we have salvaged. We still have our switch bow. We got that. We need some building blocks, some water supplies, standard torches, this wand, which I forgot to use, the summoning staff. We need to actually put that to good use. Okay. So, baubles. Yep. Alright, now let's test this bow. It should work since it's from the same mod. Yeah, it works. Okay. And boop. That should save some inventory space. Alright, let's adjust our summoning. Alright. Alright, mounts. Alright, we got that summon good. Familiars. What should we choose? Actually, that should be as pets, right? No, summoning. Alright, we got Argus, but we discovered they don't go through doorways very well. So we're gonna need a smaller mob. Kobolds, they're cute, but too passive. Reapers. Let's set this to Reapers. Okay, set that to aggressive because these guys can go through walls. So let's do that. All right, and for the second one, let's try these little jerks. I was about to say something a little more colorful, but that's what I think of these guys. These guys are nasty. Okay, so we'll go ahead and set it on that. All right, do a quick sleep. Yeah, I just logged into the game. Basically, I was thinking on what to do and doing all sorts of planning. By the way, it's about midsummer, if anyone was wondering about the seasons. So let's go ahead and summon our mount because I built a new outpost. All right. Kind of panicked. All right, let's try teleport. All right, let's try that again. All right, so zooming out, we got looted tower, alpha base, and then the looted battle tower and the looted structure. That's the faction base. This right here is outpost beta. That's where we're going next. Oh, by the way, I marked the villages that we discovered previously as looted because I picked it clean. All right, gotta get used to that. Hop, there we go. All right, now let's follow our path. Oh, got a little bit of a lag spike there, don't worry. And we'll probably do just a couple levels of the battle tower. We were just doing prep work, making sure that we were ready and all that fun stuff. All right, let's take a look. All right, we are headed in the right direction. Doop a doop a doop a doo. So, yeah, the scenery actually looks pretty good. That scenery looks pretty good. Yeah, this is going to be a little bit of a colder region, and that is the tower in question. So, that is our little base. That is going to be outpost beta. All right, let's hop into here. All right, and let's dismiss our pet before he gets into trouble. Okay, and because it's a colder region, I set a campfire here. All right, now let's go ahead, put some of the items in here. All right, I found this. Oh, I should have done a reroll on this. Yeah. Alright, that's for the spawners. Alright, I don't want to use a shield. So we'll go ahead and put in backup gear. And put this in here. Okay. Store that away. We'll store that. We'll store half of this. Okay, let's go ahead and rearrange the inventory. Sword, check. Mace, dupe. And first aid. Alright, I'm pretty sure that this works pretty well. But it's for localized damage. This, I'm not too sure about. I spam click it. But I feel like I'm not getting any good results. So as backup, we got the cooked chupacabra meats. Alright, we'll keep that there. And torches. Now, let's go ahead and put blocks here. Yeah. Alright, we'll go ahead and hit the middle mouse button. And I forgot to bring a clock. But I think... yeah. Come first nightfall, we will sleep here and set up our spawn point. We'll basically relocate our spawn point here. I just noticed this. Okay, let me listen real carefully for a second. I hear a bird, but I don't hear a dragon. Did a dragon just pass on by here, or did I do the foolish thing of not looking before building? Yeah, this looks awfully suspicious. Yeah, this wasn't here last time I was here. And it's strangely quiet. Oh god. Whoa. Alright, let's look up. There a dragon? You see a dragon nest? But if you don't see a dragon, that is not a good sign. Whatsoever. But I hear nothing. YOLO? I guess, yeah, YOLO. And hello? Anybody home? I guess the coast is clear. I'm not sure. Okay, I am going to go ahead and go under the assumption that nobody's home. We could go ahead and take a little bit of this. I think this is gold. Ooh, it makes a nice jingle sound. I am looting. YOLO. Yep. YOLO. Whoa, that fell. Looking around. All I hear are frogs in the background. Let's see. It's alright. I honestly didn't see this when I built the outpost. Yeah, I'm a little confused. Do some of these spawn, but the dragon is not home, or there's no dragon or something? I don't know. This is actually kind of small from what I've seen in other people's playthroughs. Oop. Alright, jump back, jump forward. Parkour. Yeah. I don't think anyone's home. Let me take a screenshot. Ah! I hit the wrong button. There. Okay. Oh. And I hit the wrong button again. All right, let's go ahead and deposit this in our chest. Sorry for that little diversion, but yeah, I really was not paying attention. So I am an absolute derp, and I guess we got lucky. Oh, let's see. Oh, maybe the dragon went over there. Okay, let's go ahead and drop the first of the loot in here. All right, now we're going to be a little bit careful, a little bit cautious on the first levels until we can change our spawn point. All right, and I got the Beezor Bobble, which we got from the last battle tower, which grants us immunity to poison. All right, and let's, one. Hitboxes are so annoying. All right. Oh yeah, I forgot there were holes in the ground. All right. I'm not going to bother looting the chest just yet. There's a little trick that I want to try before actually going up to the final level, and I'm going to block it off to prevent any surprise attacks. Hello? I better not. I was thinking hammer time. Can't touch this. But I don't want to get nailed for copyright. Yeah. Okay. This is going a lot easier considering that we're not on Soul Sand. Alright. Okay. So this is level 3. Back up. Ow! Fart knocker. Ooh. Alright. Hurry. Okay. Alright. Let's block that off. Can we reach? Ooh. Alright. Alright, almost nighttime. Alright. Okay, I think we're secure. We still got space in our inventory. Okay, now, here's the little trick that I want to try. There's carry-on mod in this mod pack. So if we hit shift with an empty hand, yeah. Instead of opening the chest and risk spawning the boss, we'll just take the chest out of here. Alright, and if I recall, Brilliant Me decided to do that. And basically, this is how we're going to cart the loot out without upsetting the boss. Alright, night one. We are going to set our spawn. So, doop a doop a doop a doo. All right, taking a little bit of a risk here. Doop a doop a doop a boop 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 boop. All right, dump you here and here. Boom, boom. Yes, we saved our spawn. All right. Okay, and chest. Just dump the loot. Dump the loot. All right, we got an extra one of these. Let's see what we got. It's all right. We could always use this stuff. Not one thing left behind. Okay. Yeah, all right. All right, I'm going to actually go ahead and continue in the next episode, part two. But we are actually out of time, but we already cleared the first three levels. And we're going to repeat the steps of looting the chest by picking it up, carting it out of here, to see if we don't upset the boss. So it's kind of like an experiment. Okay, so I'll go ahead and stop here, wrap it up. And yeah, we'll go ahead and pick up where we left off. So until then, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.